And hi everyone, welcome back to the YouTube channel of Wondershare Dr. Phone. We are here with another great video on FRP lock, an important built-in security feature across your smartphones. So is your phone hanging and you want to reset it but you've forgotten your password? Well, this video surely has the answer for you. So do make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel before we start this video. Go ahead and hit that bell icon for all of the latest updates across Wondershare Dr. Phone, your first choice in smartphone remedies. So let's go ahead and dive right in. So part 1, what is factory reset protection? So factory reset protection, or better known as FRP, is a security technique that protects smartphones from unauthorized access and saves their data from any threats to theft. Now, a major stronghold to your phone's security, the FRP lock, keeps hold of your device's integrity. Whether it be your Android device or iPhone, you cannot reset any data across this device without permission from your respective account. So whenever you are trying to get into selling your device to someone, or you were bought a secondhand phone from someone, it is advised that you should disable the FRP lock across your device to make sure that you can reset and access the device with a lot of ease. So part 2 is going to be how to disable the factory reset protection on Android. So as you have come to know about factory reset protection and what it represents, it is now time to provide a couple of conclusive methods to viewers for disabling FRP on your Android. So go through these methods in detail to remove FRP lock across your Android device with ease. So method number 1 is going to be by removing all Google accounts to disable FRP lock on your smartphone. So the first method that may come in your mind is to remove all Google accounts that are present across a certain smartphone. As you discontinue the regular access to all attached accounts, you are automatically disabling FRP. So look into these steps coming right up. Step number 1 is going to be to open your settings in your Android device and find the option of accounts or a similar option in the list. Step 2 is going to be that as you proceed into the accounts page, navigate to the Google accounts in the list. Step 3 is just going to be to find the remove account option on the next screen to remove Google account from your Android device. Now method number 2 is going to be using Dr. Phone screen unlock to disable FRP on Android. And if the previous method has not disabled FRP lock from your Android for you, even after removing all of your Google accounts, you should definitely consider changing your focus to other options. So the most efficient way to disable FRP on your Android comes across as Dr. Phone screen unlock for Android, which will be essentially to disable your FRP on your smartphone within minutes, as I'm going to be explaining the steps coming right now. So step 1 is going to be to download and install the latest version of Dr. Phone on your desktop. So go ahead and launch that tool and access the screen unlock option from the homepage. You should have your phone connected with a good Wi-Fi connection. Then select unlock Android screen and FRP option to continue. So step 2 is going to be to go on to the next screen, and then you need to select the option of remove Google FRP lock option in order to bypass the Google account on your Android device. Go ahead and select the appropriate OS from the available options on the next screen. And then connect your Android device with a USB cable, and once connected, a pop-up message will appear about your device information. So go ahead and confirm that message, and then you're going to receive a notification across your device. And upon receiving this notification, go ahead and click on View. In order to proceed to the Play Store, you will have to install the dedicated browser on your device. As it is already installed, go ahead and click on Open and open the browser. Add the URL, and that's going to be right over here on screen as you should be seeing it, and then once you've entered it, click on Enter. So for different versions of Android, we do have to work around this in different ways. So if you own a smartphone with any of the Android version 6, 9, and 10 OS, you need to follow the steps that I'm going to present right now. As a new page opens on the browser, go ahead and select Android 6, 9, or 10, and it's going to redirect you to the following page from there. And then click on the Open Settings button and continue over to the next window, and then you're going to have to select the PIN option on your Android device to proceed. On the next screen, you just need to select the Do Not Require option by default, and then continue with the process. Set up your PIN code and remember it for the rest of this process, and then on the next page, go ahead and click on Skip in order to proceed. And then click on the back button on the screen in order to return over to the Wi-Fi connection page, and then tap on next to continue. Enter the PIN code set in a previous step and tap continue. On displaying the Google account sign-in page, you're going to find the skip option. And make sure that you tap it, and then you have finally successfully removed the Google FRP lock from your device from there. However, if you have an Android 7 or 8 OS version, you should look across these steps. Upon opening a new page on the browser, go ahead and click on Android 7 or 8, and then download the APK as it's going to make you download that APK file, and then click on the open button after installing it. And if there is any kind of security procedure to follow, go ahead and proceed to the settings page, and then click on the option of allow from the source, and then move back to the installation. And then you need to follow the guidelines for completing the installation, as it's going to be shown for you. And then once you have completed the installation, go ahead and click on done. And then revert back to the .apk download page, and then tap on the open settings button in order to lead into your device's settings, and then find and open the option of lock screen and security in the next window, and then you need to navigate into the other security settings option that you're going to be right on screen. So go ahead and locate the option of device administrators and disable the Android device manager, and find my device services on your smartphone. While disabling these services, go ahead and click on the deactivate button to confirm this process. And then go ahead and access your device's settings and find the apps option from the list, and find Google Play services and Google Play Store to disable them separately on your device. And then reopen the settings of your device and find the clouds and accounts option. Go ahead and click on accounts to manage the accounts across your device, and then click on add account and select Google to sign in with an existing Google account. Conversely, you can just add a new account from there. And once logged in, go ahead and click on I agree in order to successfully add this Google account. So reaccess the settings and open the lock screen and security option. Proceed to the other security settings option, followed by device administrators. Enable the services of Android Device Manager and find my device that you have previously disabled. And then restart the Samsung device after completing these steps, and follow the on-screen steps in order to launch your device again. And then from there, you have successfully bypassed your Google FRP. And so for part 3, how to turn off your factory reset protection on iPhone. So what if you own an iPhone device instead of an Android device? You should not worry at all, as we have consistent solutions to turn off FRP on your iPhone in no time. So with these methods, you won't face the difficulty of removing all of these significant threats from your iPhone. So method number 1, of course, is going to be to disable the factory reset protection from iCloud settings of your iPhone. So as it resembles a lot of the methods explained across Android, you can remove a certain device across your iCloud settings to disable FRP from your iPhone. And to execute this method, do make sure that you have another device with the same iCloud account so that you can remove the FRP lock from the target device. So look into the steps I'm going to be presenting right now. So go ahead and open the settings on your iPhone, and then click on profile. Scroll down to the settings to find the respective devices that are activated across the iCloud accounts that you've used to sign in across the iOS device, and then select the respective iPhone that needs to be removed. On the next screen, click on remove from account to disable FRP lock across your device. So method number 2 is going to be using DNS method to turn off FRP on the iPhone. So if removing the device from the iCloud settings does not disable the FRP lock across your iPhone, you should consider opting for the DNS method to manipulate the server by diverting the activation path of the iPhone from the actual servers to other third-party bypass servers. So once this device is reset, go ahead and follow the steps I'm going to be explaining right now. So first things first, go ahead and turn on your iPhone, and then select language and country. Run the provided menu, and as you move into the Wi-Fi settings of your iPhone, connect with the respective Wi-Fi and click on the I icon in the current tab. Now, so disconnect the Wi-Fi that you connected to and proceed to the connection settings. Now go ahead and tap on the forget this network option to remove the Wi-Fi. Tap on the I icon and enter the DNS server IP address according to the region. And I'm going to be showing off the list right here, as you can see exactly what it is that you specifically need to go ahead and type in, as these are all going to be very different. You need to make sure that you get the right region for your device. And then once you have it typed out, go ahead and revert to the previous window, and then turn off the Wi-Fi, and then select the right Wi-Fi connection again. Through the next page, and then back in order to reach the iCloud bypass screen, and slide down the page in order to check the results of disabled FRP from your iPhone. And then you're pretty much good to go from there. So this is how you can disable FRP from your Android and iPhone device. So was this an informative video for you? Let us know your questions in the comment section. And if you loved our video, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more content just like this. So until next time, have a good one.